Let's go to line number one to Goose Bay and say good morning to the chairperson of the Senior Citizens Committee in that town, Reg Bowers. Good morning, Reg. You're on the air.
How are you this morning, Patty?
Very well, thank you, Reg. How about you?
Not bad, sir. Not bad at all.
Good man. What's on your mind this morning?
What's on my mind is that we're going down tonight at 5 o'clock at the council meeting.
Okay.
And we're putting in over 700 letters of request for council to rescind a motion that they made in the last budget where they increased the rate of tax on the senior citizens from 2 mils to 8 mils, which is some 300%.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we've the senior citizens up here have been enjoying this for a number of years, and it's been council's way of saying, well, thank you for the service that you provided to the community and hopefully be in some small way helping to keep seniors in the committee, in the community, I'm sorry.
Right.
Because a lot of people retire, they move out, and you lose your valuable, experienced people, you see. But the council walked in September and without even talking to anybody or meeting with any of the citizens, they decided to up this tax in the budget. And this means from anywhere from $1,000 to about $2,500 to any person that owns a home. And they've done this, without any consultation whatsoever. And we thought it was just unfair the way they did it, especially in the fact, light of the fact that in December, the same council is hiring Councillor Walsh from St. John's as a consultant to come in and see if they can't get an increase in their remuneration for sitting on council. We understand from the rumors around town that they're looking for something comparable to Ladd City, which means that they're going to get about a 60% increase in their remuneration. So we find this, almost unbelievable that they do this to the seniors without even talking to them. What is coming from our people, we formed a committee there 2 weeks ago with 15 of people on there, and what they're telling us, that what they're hearing from down around town is the seniors here versus any other community. Number one, they don't enjoy that 10% rebate at the stores so much as they do in, say, St. John's or Grand Falls or Quarter Brook. And not only that, up here, as you get older, of course, your medical bills increase. And in Goose Bay, we oftentimes got to fly out for any treatment for cancer or open heart surgery or anything like that. We have to go to St. John's for sometimes months on end. I talked to two guys yesterday. One told me he spent $12,000 last year. Him and his wife had to go outside for several months while she was getting treatment. And the other guy told me he spent over $8,000. So this is the kind of money that we're spending to go outside to get medical treatment. The council did not take any of these things into account.
And these are things they know full well. So 2 mils to 8 mils, this is a shocking, enormous increase anyway. What is the rate that other residential property taxpayers are paying?
Well, other residential taxpayers are paying the 8%.
They're paying 8, and so you were jacked up from 2 to the 8 that everyone else is paying.
Yes.
It's an extraordinary hike, and so this is obviously, the municipalities have very limited opportunity to generate revenue, but this seems like a strange way to do it.
Yes, but when we look at their budget, they got lots of room inside the budget. There's no reason for the tax. Like, they were not in a great big deficit. Now, they have this thing ongoing that they're trying to get a wellness center here for $21 million, and they got to raise money for that. I think that's a bit of a pipe dream, but that's besides the point.
Right.
But other than that, there was no reason. When we look at the budget, and we got people on the committee who've been past counselors and what else have you, and they looked at the budget and they said, no, we believe they got a bit of a surplus in that budget, so there's no reason for them to put that tax in, other than the fact that they want to, such and such, so he can pay for that tax.
How many people affected?
339
households. 339
households
are now suffering what wants to be, we'll just average it out, $1,000 to almost $2,500 in some instances. It's an extraordinary turn of events. We know we've got seniors living, I don't know the state of all 339 houses, but we've got seniors on fixed income who have a hard time keeping up the cost of living, let alone this kind of immediate, enormous jack up in their property tax. So this is quite something. I'm surprised.
Yeah. Well, they said down here, first they set a threshold of $33,000. And then we said, gee, you know, they said, is anybody below that? We said, anybody below $33,000 don't own a home. You just can't afford it here in this area.
Sure.
Because now, you know, Muskrat Falls has driven the cost up here right through the roof. And so you can't do that. They came out, they called a seven-minute meeting 2 weeks ago, because we put a lot of pressure on them. And they said, okay, we'll give you a reprieve for 1 year. We'll give you a discount for 1 year. If your household income, not your income, your household income, is below $50,000, we'll give you 50%. So that means if you got a son living at home with you, you got to take you and your spouse and the son and make sure that all their incomes added together is below $50,000. Well, geez, that's what happened, you know.
It's really hard to understand because, I mean, we've aimed a number of subsidies at seniors for all the obvious reasons. So this one seems like a fairly punitive move. So far as the increase in the value of property, because we know that's the, you know, the mills are the absolute key to coming up with a final number for your property tax. But what's been the increase in the property anyway? A home, say, 2 years ago was worth what, an average home compared to today?
Unbelievable. I can't say like 2 years ago, but I know the houses, say, in one part of town, we did a quick survey. Houses in one part of town that were selling for, say, like, let's say 5-10 years ago, were selling for $40,000 to $50,000, are now selling for $200,000.
Unbelievable. Yeah.
When Muskrat Falls came in, houses went right through the roof from a market point of view. And the assessment value on those same houses is now anywhere from $160,000 to $200,000. So the seniors paid these taxes over the years. You know, as your house went up, they paid the increase in tax. And we got another assessment coming down to 215. So this 300% is going to be higher again next year.
Yeah, it's the bright and the dark side of some economic boom, and seniors don't get to enjoy in some of that where they don't have access to, nor are they looking for some of the job opportunities. So all you do is suffer the cost of living increases and the cost of property taxes and otherwise. So tonight at 5 o'clock at the council meeting, it was similar to group to go. I don't know what the opportunities are to reverse these kinds of decisions, but it sounds like you have a reasonable case to proceed with, Reg.
We're going in there. And we're asking as many people in town who support us, and we went around and get letters of request to council. We didn't go and get a petition. We get a letter of request so that you read it and sign it. And we have over, like I said, over 700 in our possession right now. So there's a lot of people out there support our position. And we're asking all those people, or as many as possible, come down at 4:30 this afternoon, because council starts at 5, so you get there early. And show the support for the seniors in the community.
It'd be great to get a follow-up call in the days to come to Reggie if you have the time and the opportunity. I appreciate this morning, and hopefully you get a good turnout, because 339 houses affected and the 700 letters you have already, you know that this is not a small group. This is a large group that have real meaningful problems that they need addressed.
Yes, thank you very much.
Appreciate your time this morning.
You're welcome.
All the best, Reg. Bye-bye. Reg Barber's calling from Goose Bay, chair of the Senior Citizens Committee. From 2 mils to 8 mils, when your taxes go from $1,000 to $2,500, you know, it's one thing when we complain about the property assessments. You know, we think that municipalities do it on purpose just to generate more revenue, when in fact there's an independent body that does your assessment. The control that the councils have is over this mills rate, and so the mill rate. So when they have this control and the exercise to the point of 2 to 8 mil is really quite an extraordinary jump. Imagine if everybody suffered that kind of jump, the backlash that would be coming their way. And with the number of people that register scribes, the 339 households, that's real. And that's a huge jump in your property tax, not just solely based on the new exploding assessment of your property.